Hey everybody. All right, so today's short biography is on Constantine conquering for Christ. And today is Friday, October the 15th, 2021. All right. Emperor Constantine, born in AD 272 to 337, has been much debated among historians who question whether his conversion to Christianity was an act of faith or a political strategy. Yet despite the debate that surrounds him, Constantine did seem to experience sincere spiritual growth in his rapidly changing world. Constantine carved out his place as a sole leader of the Roman Empire by defeating his enemies in battle. First, he faced his rival Maxentius, M-A-X-E-N-T-I-U-S, in a civil war. Pagan prophets foretold Constantine's defeat, but the Lord gave him confidence in a vision of a brilliant cross with the swords. By this sign, quote, by this sign, conquer, end quote. Although many of his soldiers were pagans, Constantine was advised in the vision to mark their shields with the chi Rho, C-H-I space, capital R-H-O, a symbol formed from two letters of the Greek spelling of Christ. Despite the fact that they were outnumbered 4-1, Constantine's troops were victorious as Maxentius, M-A-X-E-N-T-I-U-S, apostrophe S, forces retreated over a bridge. Their leader fell into the Tiber River, T-I-B-E-R, and drowned under the weight of his armor. Constantine entered Rome as the undisputed ruler of the West. Constantine's victory in 312 was followed by the Edict, E-D-I-C-T, of Milan in 313, a declaration Constantine co-signed with the Eastern Imperator Licinius, L-I-C-I-N-I-U-S, whom he later defeated in 323 when he became sole emperor of the Roman world. It guaranteed religious freedom within the empire, forcing the implementation of earlier edicts of toleration that granted rights to Christians. In the Roman world, Christians had long been regarded as troublemakers, disloyal to emperors and to ancient gods celebrated by the state. A few emperors had tolerated their dissent, but others severely persecuted Christ's followers through torture, imprisonment, and death. Constantine overturned this situation, actively promoting Christianity, but refraining from imposing his newfound faith on others. The struggle for deathlessness, he said, must be free. Constantine held a strong belief and God's grace and power to lead individuals to himself. In a message he sent to an assembly of bishops in 314, he wrote about how God does not allow people to wander in the shadows, but reveals to them the way of salvation. I have explained this in others and in myself, for I walk not in the way of righteousness, but the Almighty God who sits in the court of heaven granted what I did not deserve. Constantine affected both personal and public reforms in keeping with authentic faith. Unlike many of his predecessors, he refused to be worshipped as a god. Rather, he saw himself as a bishop ordained by God to oversee those outside the church. He gave generously to the poor and made a habit of prayer. He enacted laws that protected children from violence and women from being discarded by their husbands. He released Christians from prisons and mines. Magnificent churches were built and filled. During the last 14 years of his reign, Constantine became less tolerant and proceeded to build the foundation of a state church. He banned taxation of the church and gave bishops the authority to judge legal issues. Meanwhile, Constantine behaved much like a typical Roman emperor. He ordered the executions of his eldest son, his second wife, and his sister's husband. Scholars are unable to fully explain Constantine's reasons for these actions, though such actions were certainly often associated with those in positions of unregulated power. Modern Christians differ in the issue of state religion, and many of Constantine's moral choices cannot be defended, but he is perhaps one of the history's best representations of a lifetime struggle to live out one's faith in a changing world, an especially difficult course for any person at the pinnacle of war power, a world power. All right, so it was very interesting. You know, one thing that doesn't change, no matter, you know, where we are in, you know, as far as time frame in this world, one thing that does not change, and that is the tendencies of us as humans. And, you know, people that say that there is no God, I mean, my approach to that would is to be then, if the, you know, who determines what's good and what's evil? And, you know, we're given that instinctual, feeling or knowing, you know, this is, you know, this is right and this is wrong. You know, somebody goes out and commits a sin, you know, say they rape somebody. Well, you know, not only is society, you know, it's a big no-no in society, but it's also a, as from a spiritual standpoint, it's also a big no-no. Anyway, okay, guys, I will talk to y'all tomorrow, maybe this afternoon. All right, love you, bye.